Welcome back to the oneAPI channel. Gravitational waves, ripples in the fabric of space and time caused by gravity of large, very large masses. Einstein could only imagine that. We can now simulate and visualize it. This is not easy. What you see here is a simulation of two black holes spiraling into one another, creating gravitational waves. This is a 36 terabyte simulation dataset done on multiple processors, visualized at interactive frame rate of 10 FPS. And this is all possible thanks to oSPRay. Let me tell you all about it. In previous videos, we've talked about the oneAPI components. We mentioned the multi-device, multi-vendor, and open-spec libraries that can now work on multiple devices, CPU, GPU, and others, what we call XPUs, and are arranged into toolkits. One of them is the oneAPI Rendering Toolkit that has many components. One of them is the Intel oSPRay. oSPRay stands for Open Source, Scalable, and Portable Ray Tracing. It is a rendering framework built on top of capabilities provided by Intel Embry, OpenImage Denoise, and OpenVKA library. Each of these libraries has its own capabilities and APIs, but oSPRay has its own API for writing renderers using a set of ray tracing algorithms for various applications. oSPRay Studio is an asset viewer, editor, and a dev tool that uses oSPRay and provides the basic functionality UI for building a scene and setting up materials, lights, and so on. Hydra for oSPRay is a USD universal scene description Hydra delegate, allowing USD-based scenes to be rendered with oSPRay. oSPRay supports many features: physically accurate lights and physically based materials, photorealistics, physically based path tracers, and more. oSPRay is highly scalable. It can run on your laptop, CPU, but it can also efficiently run on the largest multi-node supercomputers, and it can handle massive amount of data. Try to overload it. And these are some of the reasons why so many research institutes use it or incorporate it into their software suites. oSPRay can work on Windows, macOS, Linux. It is optimized for Intel CPUs and soon on Intel GPUs. And it is open source. If you'd like to get started, it's easy. Option 1 is to look for the Intel Dev Cloud. Choose the oneAPI Dev Cloud, get started, scroll down to the Rendering Toolkit. In the training models, you can find ready-to-use Jupyter Notebooks on programming oneAPI, Intro to oSPRay, and many other examples. Try it out. Option 2 resource is oSPRay.org. You can find here an overview, you can download and install, access the API documentation, take a look at the tutorials, and even jump directly to the code in GitHub. This one is OSP example. If you just want to try it out to benchmark the performance, get a VNC on the Dev Cloud. Instructions in this video descriptions. On your VNC session, just navigate to oSPRay directory, latest, bin, and the code is built and ready to run. Let's run the oSPRay example. And I'm getting a new window. I can rotate the view with my mouse. I can choose a different renderer. I can choose a different scene and play with the parameters. This is the oSPRay example, so you can view the code on GitHub. And this is a great example of a scene rendered with oSPRay, the Moana Island scene by Disney. OpenVKL was used for volume, like the clouds traversal. Embry was used for the surface intersections, and the OpenImage Denoise to complete the rendering. oSPRay, part of the Intel oneAPI Rendering Toolkit, open source, scalable, and portable ray tracing. Enjoy, subscribe, thank you.